Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies. Now, I recently did a video on the Townsteel 5000 series Bluetooth locks, and I was going over the four different ways you can unlock these Townsteel locks out of the box without buying anything extra, right? You can use the key, you can use the keypad, you can use a RFID card, a few come included with the lock, and then you can also use the Bluetooth app. And well, we ended up accidentally deleting the footage off of that video. We're not putting that footage on there. And so I only gave you three of the four options. Well, today we're gonna solve that, and I'm gonna go over the Bluetooth side of these 5000 series Townsteel locks. Now, what is important is that if you get one of these, now there's a couple options with the 5000 series. There's the Bluetooth option, and then there's the Wi-Fi option. So what I'm going to be going over today is the Bluetooth option, and you don't need to purchase anything else to use that operation. All you need to do is go to your app store and download the TSE Home app. I think you're going to be super impressed with the capabilities that the free app has for these locks. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, now the first thing that you're gonna wanna make sure that you do is download the TSE app. Once you do that, open it up. Now you can download that at any Play Store that you have, whether it's Android or iPhone, all right? And then go ahead and click on the app, and this is the screen that you're going to see. And so what we wanna do is we wanna set up our first device. So I'm gonna click that, and then we're gonna go to Bluetooth lock. Okay, if you have the Wi-Fi lock, you know, you can see those options in there, but we're just gonna go right to Bluetooth lock.
Press the reset button and release it.
Okay, so as you can hear, the computer-generated voice telling us to press the reset button. Now, I already went ahead on the back of this lock here, and I've taken off the cover. Okay, so essentially all of the Townsteel locks are gonna look fairly the same, and you're just gonna hit the little reset button right here, okay? So I'll click it. As you can hear it, made a little bit of a noise. And then I'm gonna hit next.
The lock is adding. Please wait patiently.
All right, so we'll let it go through and connect. All right, so it's really that simple to connect the two. Now, of course, you have to make sure on your phone you have your Bluetooth setting on so you can connect. And, you know, it's always recommended when you're using a Bluetooth lock that you're gonna be 10, maybe 15 feet away max when you're trying to connect to the lock, all right? So let's go ahead and we'll set the time zone. I'm on Pacific time, so that's the one I'm gonna choose, and I'm gonna hit completed.
Add successful. Please set the information.
All right, so there you have it. So it's really that simple. Now we can get in here, we can change the name to lock test video, why not? And we'll just save it. All right, so we can see everything on here. We can see the battery life, we can see all the fun stuff, okay? Now, let's just hop into the good stuff right away. So a lot of you have been asking about Audit Trail, all right? And let's just get right into it right now. So there's two different methods of Audit Trail on here. There's like the lock access, and then there's like the daily log of what kind of happens, all right? Now, this lock holds 2,000 events in it. So after 2,000 events have occurred, it's gonna start deleting the oldest, when it's adding a new one. So it's gonna be a rolling 2,000 event log, all right? And how you get to that is you go in here to settings, and then you go to device information. You go to activity log. And then you just wanna make sure, you know, your phone's within reach of the lock, Bluetooth wise, and you'll click load. And this is what it'll look like. So it's gonna, right now it's dumping all the information. You can even see the little star was lighting up there while it was dumping the information, okay? So as you can see, it's gonna load all of this information. Now the admin is always gonna be user 900, okay? So that's how that works. That's and you'll see other stuff that's happened here. So today is February 5th when I'm doing this. And you can see on February 3rd, there was a key card unlock. You can see on, there's also a temporary user. I'll show you how to do that in a while. User 4 did a password unlock, so on and so forth. Now, all of it's gonna be here, but it being on your phone doesn't necessarily help you, right? And so what you can do is hit the share button and you can generate a text file and you can, you know, send it off to however you'd like. Okay, so that's how that's going to work. Okay, that's how the audit trail works. That's how you can look at it. Now, when we go back to this first setting here, okay, or on the home page, you can see these events, and we'll go back to it at the end, and you'll be able to see all the events that have taken place since we've been recording this video. Now let's get back into settings here. Let's look around for a second. You'll see a device QR code. Okay, so it's very important that if you're gonna have your customers use this device and use all these functionalities, it's really, really good if you get them to download the app, all right? And then once they download the app, you can click on device QR code. They can just scan this. You can send it to them if you want as well. And then it's just gonna pop up the lock information. It's really, really simple. You can also add, two-factor authorization. You can even add the scan frame fingerprint to unlock. Okay, so there's all those options. And if you want to delete the device, you can see the delete button right there. You can click it and the device is gone. All right, so let's get into the users. All right, so as you can see here, I'm the only user on here right now. They call it keys is what they call it, but it's users. You can get in here and you can add a key, all right? And you can add a PIN code or you can add a key card, all right? So it's gonna allow you all the functionality that you want here. So let's go ahead, so you can go to the PIN code. So you need to enter the password. Now you have to, so what we'll do here is we'll pick one up. We'll just make one up really quick. So let's just go 258258. Okay, you can look at that real quick and then hit complete. Now it's communicating with the lock because I'm in range, and now we can get on here and we can try it, all right? Let's lock it up. Let's go 258258. There you go. Just like that, you're in. So it's that simple. You can add them on your phone as quickly as you'd like. Now let's go to the key card, all right? So we'll click on that. So what it's doing is it's just gonna allow you, it just pops it into mode. Now I showed you the manual way to do it, but through the app you can do it this way. Then you just bring up a card, you click it, and now it's done, right? It's really that simple. So now that it's out of the mode here, let's get out of programming mode. Then we can use it. And it's that simple to add cards. So you can add them very, very quickly, all right? And then when you get in here to the app, you can assign user, okay? So you can add related user, you can add that through the app and all of that fun stuff as well, okay? So that's how that works to add a normal code to add a RFID card. But I wanna get into probably my favorite part about this, and this is the temporary user keys. Now, what you do is when you get in here, now for this part, you actually don't need to be next to the device at all. So you could be, 100 miles away, it doesn't really matter. And for this feature, you can get someone in the door, in the lock, when you need them to. And let me show you how to do that. So you're just gonna click on add temporary key. All right, and then you're gonna get in here and you can set, it can be 1 week, 1 month, 1 year, 1 day, you can customize it, start, end day, all of that fun stuff. As soon as you do that, you have it set, all you need to do, you can enter a name. Let's put Joe in here, why not? And just hit send. All right, now this information here, okay, you can send a message, you can copy the text, you can share via, all that fun stuff. But this is what's really cool, is you're gonna see this big 15-digit long code up top there. Now that code, since the lock and the app are synced together, it knows, you know, Townsteel put some of these 15-digit temporary codes in here. So at this point, you can just give them that code and it's gonna get them in for, you know, in the door. It's gonna get them in. So let's go ahead and put this one in here, okay? It's kind of long, so let's lock it and then let's put it in here. Now, of course, my phone is within range. I'm just standing right off screen here. But it doesn't matter in this case, okay? So let's just go ahead and just put it in here. So it's 07. There you have it. So you can, they're long codes, but you can definitely make it work, all right? And that's really the fun part about this. So that's how you can do temporary codes to get people in. And then we can go back here to lock users. Now, when I first saw this, I thought, is this how you like lock users out? And the answer is no, this is the lock users, all right? So when you wanna add another user to this lock, that's how you do it. You click add user, and you go through and you can send an invitation and do all of that kind of stuff. So that's how you go through and that's how you can add users. Now, I wanna be clear on this. So this app is awesome. As you can see, it has all these cool features. However, at this time, I know this is a question you're gonna ask, is if once we get this lock completely set up and we have another one in the building, can I transfer all the information? And right now the answer is no. You would have to do this for each lock on the premise or building or whatever you needed to do. So now I did call Townsteel and I talked to them about it, and it is on their radar, and it's something, I mean, I like how I kind of felt after the call was it's something that they're working on and they're hoping to have. So that would be amazing, truthfully, if you could set everything up on one lock, go to another one and just dump all the information in it. But right now that is not an option. So I just want to be crystal clear on that. So it is a little more legwork to set up each one. However, sometimes each lock has different access requirements. So it's really not the end of the world, because sometimes you have to do special programming for that anyways. But that's how the app works. All right, and there you have it. The Bluetooth 5000 series lock with the TSE Home app is a really great combo between the audit trail and the one-time use codes and being able to look up and see what's going on and manage the users, manage RFID cards, all of that fun stuff wrapped up inside of this lock. And you have to admit, being able to purchase this lock and download that app to have all of those audit trail features without any extra fees, it's pretty cool. I'd love to know what you think. Tell me in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Here we go. So let's go ahead and get started. Super impressed with the capabilities the app has. Now, before we're done with this video, since you just watched this video, I'm guessing that you work with locks and keys. And to us at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss, and we want to hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, join the conversation and comment on our posts and videos and include the hashtag lockboss. It's free to enter this giveaway, and every Tuesday we're going to pick 5 winners from the previous week and hook you up with all sorts of prizes, including gear, tools, supplies. We might even send you a key machine or buy you lunch. So if you're a lock boss, join us every week to learn, grow, and win.